I'm just telling you, don't talk to me.
I just can't. I can't.
Jesus.
Who is that?
Things are recording, so I will not say.
Are they recording now?
Oh.
We are recording, sir.
Has it started?
Everything is starting, sir.
T-minus now.
T-minus now seconds.
T-minus now seconds.
Hey!
Yes, sir.
Episode 18.
Android 18.
All right. Wow. This is unbelievable.
Android 18 should be the episode.
I'm not going to name it Android 18. And I don't appreciate you telling me what the name should be nowadays.
Okay, so what's wrong with Android 18? Let me hear this.
Let me tell you something, because I don't have... Can you let me have my little sliver of responsibility for this podcast behind the scenes?
Go ahead. Go ahead, brother.
Now, this conversation should have happened behind the scenes, but the camera's rolling now.
I'm not sure if it's a sliver, sir. This is super.
No, it's a, you know what I mean.
It's a tall order.
I don't mind. I'm only being that for the cameras because it's hard to come up with episode names. I understand Savon's issues. Anyway, I am JR the Geek. It's Fat to my left, and Judah is handling things behind the camera, shooting. Because he is the what?
The shooter.
There we go. This is episode 18, Conversations with Elephants.
Android 18 is what it's going to really be called.
You're going to say that every time.
Because right. Android 18 was great.
16 was the goal,
yo. You like Android 16?
The one who died for our sins.
Quite frankly, yeah. Yo, I saw that episode.
That man said for our sake.
Yo, okay. Okay, he's right. He's right, by the way. First of all, I saw the episode like not too long ago. Could that be not the greatest ending in Dragon Ball Z history?
That might be the greatest ending in television history.
Like,
I'm not gonna lie, that shit was legendary.
Yo,
Yes.
He said, "Die for our sin." All right, I'm sorry.
Yeah, when Gohan turned Super Saiyan,
I saw the scene.
Did you see the ending part though? When he's with the tears are flowing and he just, come on, bro.
Come on, bro.
The most iconic closing in the series history, bro. Saw this as a child.
In the whole series.
In the whole series, bro.
I understand you.
It's a secret we learned since Gohan was a child through fights with Raditz. Frieza, Vegeta, and now Cell's gonna find a warrior 11 right. years in the make.
Anyway, let's start. How are you doing?
Yo,
you do sound exactly like that dude who does the
book. I've watched that way too many times.
You've seen it at least 1,000 times.
At least 1,000. Easily. Yo, I'm doing, quite frankly, kind of alright today. Not too bad. Not too bad of a Monday, considering the circumstances. Not too bad of a Monday. Can't complain today.
Circumstances being the Rona?
Yes, the Ronies.
The Rona pandemic?
The Tenderoni. Don't shoot me if I ever say that again.
What is wrong with you today?
I don't have no idea.
I'm going to need you to tone it down.
Just a little bit. I'm going to have to. You're right.
He said, I'm going to have to.
Straight up.
No, I'm just playing. Keep the energy.
No, but I'm doing all right today.
But shoot me if I
Yo, I said tenderoni.
Crazy.
I just called the coronavirus the tenderoni virus.
And don't do that.
Don't do that again, because that's a great song.
That's an amazing song.
That's an amazing album. But, you know, we're not here to talk about the great OG Bobby Brown, King Bobby. How you doing today, Judah?
King Bobby, huh? That's the way to live your life.
I mean, ask me. I can't concur.
What? Is that too much?
I can agree, I guess.
Yeah, man, we're making it.
That's great, bro. Yo, new music weekend. Yo.
We need a soundboard.
We do need that. We do need a soundboard. Yo, the After Hours album. Yo, what are we thinking? Yes,
The Weeknd.
Shout out to The Weeknd for dropping the After Hours album. Probably, quite frankly, one of the more anticipated albums that I've been waiting for a while. But
that's a fact.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, I heard somebody describe it as high grade mid. I don't know if I kind of would go that far with the album, with saying what it is.
Who said that?
Is yeah, some it's,
that is a crazy
high grade mid. It was like they were like, it smelled good. Yeah. Like, it smelled good. It looked good, but it don't get you. You know what I'm saying?
That's kind of disrespectful. That's a good. It was a good album. I didn't listen to the whole thing.
It was an expensive album.
An expensive album?
Yeah.
What you mean?
I mean, it has a short film
to make.
Attached.
What?
Yeah.
Short film attached to it, so. Oh, well, yeah. I mean, that makes sense.
I mean,
great, yeah, music
video. What movie is that from?
Production was.
You did kind of. I don't know.
Nah, cause he.
I don't know.
That whole shit is from a movie.
Yo, we got to, yo, so what do we think? Are we in agreement that the first half of the album is probably the better part of the album, or what? Y'all, what? First
I can agree with that.
First quarter, maybe.
The
I can agree with that.
Man, it got really 80s, like, towards the, like, at, in the second half of the album, and I don't think I don't know how I feel about that.
Did you say really 80s?
Like, really 80s.
Oh, like poppy?
Yeah, really poppy.
Pop-ish. I understand your life.
Is that Jimmy Kimmel?
James Kimmel, that's him.
Don't call him that, please. You do not know that's the name of this episode.
That's what Jimmy is short for.
Is it?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm 1,000% positive.
Do you know him? To be calling him James Kimmel?
I don't know him at all, but I know that's what Jimmy is short for.
You got me off track.
Or Jim is short
for. You got me off track.
You right.
Listen, I think, so what do we think about the album, guys? React to the album.
I reacted.
No,
for a person that hasn't heard the whole album. So I think y'all should react.
You react. You don't never have opinions about anything, do you?
I have an opinion about everything.
You don't.
That's what I'm here for.
You don't.
Is to spread non-thought-out opinions.
All right.
They would call those impulses. Snow Child was amazing. Escape yeah. LA, amazing. Art, this is my new AM anthem. And there was one more. I just remembered.
Because of Heartless.
Hey.
There's one more on that list, but I appreciate the first few.
From I think it was from 1 to 6 where it was just like, it was actually a continuation of My Dear Melancholy. Because that's what he was trying to, I mean, that's what he was at least telling us on via Twitter, because he doesn't do interviews. You know, The Weeknd doesn't talk to people.
He doesn't talk, period.
Yeah, at all. So he was, you know, I mean, I guess.
But such a caricature in his videos.
Yeah, for being, I mean, he's an anomaly. We haven't seen anything like The Weeknd, like, ever.
Yeah.
Or heard anything like The Weeknd ever.
That's a fact.
So, I mean, I guess being an anomaly, you have to do things abnormal, I guess. But the first half is, I mean, it would have been cool for me if he would have kept it the same length like he did in My Dear Melancholy, 6 or 7 songs like he did.
Yeah. I knew he wasn't going to do that, though. I knew that.
Maybe 10. Maybe 10 at least. Because I think that's what had the effect of My Dear Melancholy was. It was short, but it was just so, it was so good, bro.
Yeah, really.
Like, My Dear Melancholy was just so great.
That was probably prequel to this.
It definitely was. Or this was a continuation of that.
Instead of like a second or a first half, that was just like a prequel. And then what is going on in this video, man? He is tripping me out.
Yeah.
Right, this is still after the Jimmy Kimmel or James Kimmel
song. Brother, he has to. I'm only calling him James Kimmel for the rest of my life.
Wow.
We have to find out what this movie, what he is acting out.
Yo, this movie.
The mustache, I'm telling you, that's from something. It gotta be.
The beat up face, all that.
Yeah, all that. It's from a movie. I just don't know. If you know, tell us in the comments. I tried to look it up. Couldn't find it in time. We still need an assistant.
We still need an assistant.
Pay you one day.
We need an intern.
We need an intern, what you meant
there
to say.
We go.
Intern.
That's how you dip and dash right there,
and that's
boys.
How we do that.
Yo, so how do we feel about, so Party Mobile is going to be better than this. Party's album is going to be better. Safe to say?
It's not safe to say.
Safe to say, yeah. I'm ready for Party's album?
Safe to say I'm ready, yeah.
I'm ready. This week, isn't it? Yes, sir. This yeah. week.
Voided from this combo. I've really never been a fan of either one of them.
But what?
If Party comes out and it's good, then I'll have something else to talk about.
So you don't like the After Hours?
Wow.
No pun intended.
Come on, it's not.
He said that he didn't say all of that now.
Words in people's mouths.
So what you're saying is you never liked
no,
this.
No. I said what I said. What's your question?
I like that. I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna use that. No, so you don't think Party's album gonna be better than this?
I don't know.
He just said he ain't. He's not the biggest.
So both parties involved. So, but I stand by what I say. I appreciate at least a third.
I'm childish.
At least a third of this album, I like sonically the whole project. I appreciate.
God, I appreciate you.
I'll anticipate Parties. I don't know. I'll listen to it when it comes out.
I got you. Has all the safe answers.
He does have all the PC answers. No, I feel you.
We want to talk about J. Cole, Kendrick, Mick Jenkins.
No, okay. That's where you crack it open.
Yeah, let's get emotional with them. But.
In other words, the real rappers.
Bow.
So that's just saying the real rappers.
This man is shooting shots today.
He wants somebody to hate me.
Somebody. Why are you bringing all the smoke dude away?
Nah, there's a few artists I'm familiar with that I could definitely speak more heavily on. The Weeknd, Party are not
in that number.
Yeah, in that category. Thank you, sir.
So have you ever listened to House of Balloons?
Not thoroughly.
So that means you never listened to Thursday.
Mm-hmm. I hate how much I'm disappointed you right now.
Yo, we did this the last episode.
No, we haven't. No, we have not.
You know what I'm saying? Like with Travis Scott.
I was saying it's probably about different artists.
Yeah, remember? And he was like, nah.
Yo, you have homework tonight. You need to get in the time machine.
Yeah, you have homework for the whole month.
You need to get in the time machine and go back to about 2012.
It's too late to look. Yo, you got to go way bike.
You got to go back to 2012, House of Balloons.
Noted.
You want to lose? You never heard that thoroughly?
In like, passing, you
like,
mean?
Like you just never sat
there. Passing, definitely, but I can't name a track, a lyric.
You are breaking my heart, sir.
I'm sorry, sir.
Whoa.
This is crazy, bro.
Bro, that's the best.
I mean, last week it was Travis Scott.
I probably okay. play like Mick Jenkins or Drake or something while she was playing. Oh boy, House Balloons.
I mean, can I make the argument that was the best form of the weekend?
I mean, yeah.
What? House of Balloons?
And Thursday weekend, the 2012, 2013 weekend?
I'm going to go there. I will go there. That's my favorite project, House of Balloons.
Like, that was the best form of the weekend.
Well,
like,
that's something to look forward to.
That's the first, I mean, and it's the first installment, if you will.
I don't think he's made better music than that since he came out, bro.
He said that was, like, mostly, like, freestyle, too. Like, I don't know if he meant, like, concept-wise or just lyrics, because
that's what a lot of his new ones sound.
But this
what?
Album sounds expensive, like the production.
This?
Nah.
I feel like he's really been with the pen game ever since.
Yeah, since he got
after
in the big
House
leagues.
Of Balloons.
I think way after Echoes of Silence.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I'd have to see his recording process.
Oh, you won't see it.
Thorough,
because he is a complete mystery.
He records it in the cave.
A cave.
Don't steal what I was finna say.
I was finishing it because you were choking.
I wasn't choking. I was burping.
Whatever. Bodily function.
This do a battle rap. Oh, you thought I was...
this nigga here, son.
No, I did this, and this.
Hey, yo.
No, this nigga's crazy, yo. Yo, Jude, I got a question for you. Hey, did you grow up watching Sister, Sister?
Wow.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Like 1,000, like, yo. Happily.
This man is crazy.
But why?
Let me ask you a question.
I'm going to just tell you right now before he even asks you. He's crazy. Yo. We had this debate over the weekend, and this man is crazy. I want all the viewers and listeners. The floor is yours, sir.
All I simply said was Marcus Houston was a very, very essential part.
That's not all you said.
What I say?
Good enough. Finish your statement.
No, and then I'll
tell you how you're wrong.
All I said was Marcus Houston was a very, by the time, because he said that Marcus Houston probably only got 5 racks to show. Brother, Marcus Houston was a number one artist by this time, dog. At least, he was well into his scene.
I'm not finna, okay, I gotta cut you off. I'm not finna let you do this, because you scattering all over the place. And you're making me seem like a different person. Because you said by the time, and you didn't say by the time when we was debating. You said from the jump.
From the jump, when he got on the show.
In 1994.
He dropped his album in 92. IMX dropped in 92.
He was 5 years old.
He still dropped in 92. He was on the
okay,
radio.
My debate was, the price per episode was hypothetical. What I was saying was, I was saying 5 racks in comparison to what you had said. What did you say, like 20 racks an episode? I don't know, but what I was thinking, the numbers are irrelevant here in the conversation. What he was basically saying was, Marcus Houston, from the jump, from the beginning of this program series, was getting paid more. Did you say more?
I didn't say more.
Twins, the star of the show, who the show was about, because of his stature of him being in an R&B group as a child.
And
I said he's wrong.
Of who
he was
a
guest star at the beginning. Then he became a main
character.
He
was a cult star from the beginning of the...
He ended up being a main character, no doubt. But from the jump, no way.
Tim Reed and Jack A. Harris were main characters.
I don't know. That's
facts. They're the parents.
Who they were before the show started.
Jack, yeah. There are people outside the family that are main characters. That's
before they started.
But,
what do you mean?
No, I wouldn't.
They were already doing their thing in the industry before the show even started. This was just another show for them.
Well, yeah, but we were saying main characters of the show.
Marcus Houston is definitely a main character of the show. That's one of the
most... By the end of the series, 1,000%.
No way!
From the jump, from the beginning of the series?
Gohan Rogers on the pilot episode. That's probably the most iconic thing from the whole episode. The most iconic slogan from the episode.
Was he in every episode?
Yes!
I'm still
no.
being a main character for one. Two, I would off the jump say he did not get paid more than Tia Tamara.
Because the show was
about
them.
Of course not,
them.
It's them.
I don't know that Tia Tamara got paid too much either.
But he was making it seem like Marcus Houston wasn't a no, but like he was just
That's
like,
not what I was saying.
You was making it seem like Marcus, you're like, okay, so he dropped, he was like 5 years old. He did it.
Fam, your argument.
Dave, have y'all seen Lil Dicky's new show?
I haven't watched it yet.
So there's cameos in it.
Right.
Yeah.
Other people have cameos. Anyway, it probably got negotiated somewhere. It probably started off as cameo type. Because, like you said, he was already notable.
Yes.
Group, so maybe it started out as cameo.
Which I didn't take nothing from that.
Even in the, when they do pilots and ratings and yada, yada, yada. Like, the Family Guy parody of, oh, man, your ratings are low. We need to switch you.
Right.
So maybe his
writing
just got high. But I don't know.
Your argument would be. I don't disagree with your argument because that's the same thing that happened in the Steve Urkel show. On the Steve Urkel show. On Family Matters, because Steve Urkel was somebody who was. You need to quit touching that. Put it down. Drop it. No, on Family Matters, because Steve Urkel was, like, just like you're talking about, just somebody who's just coming on the show, like a cameo appearance.
Exactly.
But he eventually took over the show.
Yes.
But contributing to a show and being a main character, I think it's, there's probably...
They called it the Steve Urkel show. People didn't even know the name of the show for a while.
That show, hell yeah. But we're talking about Sister, Sister.
It's a thin line, but the line exists between being...
Okay, second season.
Yeah.
Only so many main characters, and then you have the
co-stars.
Non-main characters, you know, that are still in
All I'm saying was telling this man, quit disrespecting the
I did not disrespect Marcus Houston. Yo, y'all gotta, I gave him all the credits and the props.
Like, proppers. This man wasn't on the radio at such... Yo, house, when did House Party 3 come out? Do you know?
That's what I was going to bring up.
That's yeah, that's what I'm saying. When did House Party 3 come up? And the only thing
that's fine.
And the only thing I asked him to bring up was, what did Tia and Tamera Mary do before Sister Sister?
They didn't have to do a bitch-ass thing. They were twins, and they wanted to make a show about them.
There was something else dynamic about this show. Was the dad actually their dad or something?
Nope.
There's something else dynamic about the cast.
He... No.
Anyway.
But that's what we was talking about. I was just like,
I don't know. Or maybe you talking about their brother, but he wasn't on there.
You think of Taj Mowry?
Yeah, he wasn't on that show.
Cause he had
they ended up being on his show though.
He came on there once or twice.
Did he? It was only like three seasons. When we were debating the other day, I looked it up and found out.
Who's on three? Smart guy.
Nah, Sister Sister. It wasn't that long.
Sister Sister was nowhere near three seasons.
It's on the internet.
It was six seasons at least, bro. It gotta be. Bro, three seasons.
I looked it up. Why don't you want to debate with me about everything?
Because, bro, it's no way Sister Sister was three seasons.
Crazy, man.
No way Sister Sister was six. Look what we debating, bro.
That's what I'm saying. You debating.
We debating, bro. It's a coronavirus. You're debating Sister Sister, bro.
It's a quarantine podcast.
The quarantine podcast, quarantine guys. Pod. Nah, but bro, I don't.
This man is absolutely right. It was six seasons, and I got my foot in my mouth.
At least you tell him. You know what? And we can drop
said it. And
we can drop it. You drop know, it, we can drop it. You said.
Finish what you was finna say. Coronavirus.
Coronavirus. Shout out to Cardi B.
Oh God!
Shout out to whoever edited that though.
Yo, shout out to the edit. Shout out to the DJ who edited that. Yo, over the weekend. Yo, for sure.
Facts.
For sure. Yo, over the weekend we saw like a lot of like online creatives like holding it down. Like a lot of online DJs, online like concerts. Yo, shout out to DJ D Nice, yo, for probably throwing.
Thanks.
Shout out to whoever got those pictures of Deep Ellum for Saturday night. Deep Ellum.
Whoa, what happened?
Stupid vacant. I can't think of the photographer's name, but.
Yo, that was like 2016. We used to walk down Deep Ellum with our bottles in our hand.
What happened?
It's like a some trendy pictures. Thing photographers are doing.
Saying how fucking vacant it is
like
now.
Joe Budden's photographer, well, not his photographer, the dude named Jay and Sylvia, or Silva. He had a trend going in New York where they would just go to notable places.
Word.
And take pictures of them now with them being vacant. And anyway,
I bet that's true. Some
photographer in Dallas did it down at Depot. Looked really nice.
I know it's a trip.
Nah, that's just weird as hell. Like, shit being, like, shut down, like, for real.
And then to enforce it.
All right, my bad.
Into it, you know?
Yo, this that's, shit that's is getting nuts.
That's where it's funny. Because now it's becoming more of the movie type.
Mm-hmm. Deal. No, 1,000%.
Where you going, son?
Yeah, all that shit.
I'm going to my grandmother's house. By, where's your grandma stay? She stays off the road. Well, why aren't you going this way? You know what? Nah, just come with me.
Fuck out of it. I'm running. I'm taking off.
80 days in jail for $1,000. I don't want to do either one of those.
At all, in fact.
Neither one of those sounds great to me.
Neither one of those options sounds good.
Where'd that come from?
What?
That. 80 days, what, like?
180 days in jail.
For what?
Being out. During the quarantine.
But it kind of, it breaches into your point of podcasting being part of media, being part of, what's the word?
First responders.
First responding group. So, you have that, but now you have to have an officer that believes you.
It's all about the
that,
proof.
Yeah, they're finding you. 180
days in jail or $1,000
ticket. Since when? Since I'd have to look up the date, maybe overnight last night.
No, ain't know nothing about that. They just said stay at the house. They talk about in-home shelter. That sounds different to what I heard. But, you know, it could be, you know what I mean?
No, they have mentioned that a couple of days ago. They were talking about they was getting ready to enforce it. If you out.
Yeah, we'll see. But anyway.
Yeah, this virus shit is getting
But it's causing creatives online to start doing things like having online concerts and having probably the greatest online DJ and event, party, whatever you want to call it, online ever. Like, shout out to DJ D-Nice for probably throwing the greatest online
party ever
of all time. 100K views, presidents, future presidents, former presidents.
Everybody checked it out.
Like, it was dope. Like, I didn't know none of the songs he was playing because I'm not part of that 30 and up crowd.
Okay, yeah.
There's a lot of music in there, you know what I mean? But I'm pretty sure if that was like a real party, I would probably just probably been in the smoking section.
I'm always
in the smoking section.
Brother. You know what I mean? That right I
would
now. Probably,
if that party was a real thing, I definitely would have been in the smoking section doing my thing.
1,000%. Don't do that.
You gotta quit.
Please do not do that.
You gotta stop doing that on camera, bro.
You gotta stop doing that, period.
You gotta stop doing that, period, for sure.
All right. Just say what I said. Huh?
Oh, whatever, bro. But, yo, but it's like...
Nah,
it's
forcing, 1,000%, bro. Like, I agree with you.
But it's like forcing people to, like, be creative and start doing different things. Like, Sway Lee. Shout out to Sway Lee having, like, an online concert. Like, this yo.
Yo, he was being childish, bro. Crowd surfing and all that shit. Like,
bringing people, like, calling people, bringing people on stage. Like, you gotta do things just that like
was
that.
That was lit, though.
Nah, that shit like that, like shit like that is lit. Like people, like you just seen online, like going down your timeline, seeing different people go live on the DJ and Tim, like saying we could throw like the livest party.
People are like really taking advantage of being making the best out of a bad situation,
like a terrible fucking situation.
Yeah, like, and I think it's dope.
I think it's great, bro. Like I just tell the creators,
and all the introverts, we are in here.
Yo, creatives.
It is our time. You hear me?
Everything I need.
Yo, creatives, keep creating.
Oh yeah, that threw a lot of people for a loop. I was like, what the fuck?
I thought you were gonna say it threw you for a loop.
No, absolutely not. No, you won't catch the geek in any local gyms. I'm sorry, brothers and sisters. I will not be in the gyms.
Mr. Cruz.
You want to catch me working out? You might catch me at a skate park or something, but not in the gym.
Yo, shout out to Coach Carter.
What is happening right now? Is this Coach Carter right now on the screen?
Live-ass movie.
Yo, screen, man? No. Coach Carter was a great film.
I saw that shit in the movie theater stuff.
I'm sorry?
What is that?
Illegal Tender?
What is that?
Oh, my. A movie y'all need to watch.
Illegal Tender?
Yeah, Illegal Tender. That's my guy. Why can't I think of his name right now?
Light Skin?
Yeah. But,
Puerto Rico.
Cruz?
Cruz.
But he has a real name, fellas.
That's that nigga name.
Well,
Mr. Cruz.
They know.
That nigga name, Mr. Cruz. His name is Mr. Cruz.
Mr. Cruz.
Dude, super suave. And, but anyway, yeah, watch Illegal Tender. It's really good, man.
Hey, you gotta just roll with it. You gotta just roll with it.
Yo, fellas. I'm off.
I gotta check it out. Was that it? Oh, I'm sorry. Hey.
It's all good. But listen, yo, listen.
I'm sorry.
No. I gotta let you know. It's cool. You know what I mean? They hold me. I don't care this time. You know what I'm saying? I'll tell you off camera. I'll tell you off camera, fool.
Okay, I'm sorry. I gotta get together. Nah. My bad. That shit was fucking funny.
But no. It's all good, bro. Yo, as y'all can see, we having a very good time on this podcast. We just really just trying to have, like...
make the best out of a bad situation.
Yeah, man. We just really glad, like...
Quarantine pod.
Quarantine pod, for real. But seriously, though, guys, we really want you guys to stay safe out there. Like, keep washing your hands, keep washing your ass, you dirty bastards.
Yeah, don't go nowhere. Sit down, stay in the crib.
So, sidebar.
The bar is yours.
I just saw a Chipotle episode of that new
Chipotle episode?
Chipotle commercial.
Okay.
Of that goddamn white cheese.
The white cheese queso?
My God.
I think I might be adulted enough to try queso. My taste buds have never.
That shit is glorious.
Rotel. Nah, let me get shredded cheese.
No.
Judah, I don't even know who you are by this episode anymore. Nah. Episode 18, I thought I knew you, and you are a different person.
Judah telling me he doesn't listen to The Weeknd?
Break up with me because of, like, find out who I am.
Really?
Like, what? You don't eat melted? You don't eat liquid cheese?
Is it over?
Are you kidding me?
We're not doing this.
I'm done.
She can't do it?
She brought me a plate of Rotel, and I denied it.
Oh, you can't do that, bro.
Yo.
Because that's probably the only thing she know how to make,
She left you off the Rotel? Yeah. That's how she know how to cook, Judah?
You know what? That's the only thing she know how to cook, probably, bro.
You said it.
Man.
You were thinking
Shout out to Shorty.
Don't quit calling her Shorty.
What? I don't know her name, hell.
Shout out, Shorty.
What are y'all, from New York, right?
This is all theoretical. Hypothetical.
This is all hypothetical.
Allegedly.
Alleged.
This is allegedly.
All of the above.
Nah. So what you say? She like, so you don't want my Rotel?
She just got excitedly ate it by herself.
She had a lot of thoughts while she was eating that plate or bowl.
Okay, then let me know, like, okay.
Yeah, okay.
Like, one of those? Like the three okays? Like,
no, it was the okay. But
absolutely.
This nigga don't appreciate me.
This nigga don't like liquid cheese, fool.
She looking at me just like that.
Yeah. Like, everybody like nacho cheese.
I don't know why I remember this so vividly.
Because it's probably the only thing she know how to make, you crush her dreams.
She tried to cook other stuff. Like,
Alfredo.
Spaghetti.
Alfredo.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Shout out. Never mind. I'm done shouting out. Let's stop it.
It's not about us.
Let's not.
Why do you keep shouting out this nigga Shorty?
I didn't shout her out anymore. I wasn't about to shout her out.
A former Shorty before we started recording, dog. Don't.
He got you on What's That Camera and the recording. He got you. You know how I mean?
Yo, did this just happen right now on the episode?
Speechless.
He's speechless.
He done brought the pre-pod into the pod.
Judah just turned heel on me. Judah just hit me with the steel chair.
Out of nowhere.
Judah just said, Rollins.
What the hell was that?
What the hell? What the hell is he doing? What the hell?
He's going under the ring.
Oh, my God. Stop it! Judah just hit me with a steel chair. Judah just Seth Rollins me.
It's over, brother.
It's, oh my God. Oh my God.
Yo.
You turned heel to it, left the ring?
What the fuck? How did I get into it?
Oh my God. You just let him hit me with the chair?
I wasn't even in the match, brother.
Oh my God. Also, you was in the gorilla position.
This is crazy. I'm not involved.
Oh, it's a free for all. It's a free for all. The Royal Rumble.
Yo, this is insane.
We ain't worried about Judah or his former
shorties.
We ain't worried about his former shorties.
Allegedly.
We're just potting.
Now we potting, fellas.
Yeah, that's the same energy there, yo.
Yo, again, but like I was saying, before, I was rudely interrupted by myself. Yo, shout out to you guys. You guys have been giving us some great feedback during this time. We want you guys to stay safe. Guys,
and keep the feedback
safe. Keep giving us feedback. Keep giving us feedback. We need that straight up.
1,000%.
And
on production too.
Yes, sir.
Straight up.
On everything, whatever.
Everything.
Criticize.
We're here.
We are here for it. Straight up. We want all of that. Straight up. Because you guys make the podcast what it is.
That's a fact.
You guys are the reason we're here. Because
it ain't fiction.
It ain't. I used to get that confused with the other one.
Fiction and nonfiction?
I used to get that wrong all the time back in the day.
Let's talk about it. I'm here with you.
Yo,
Corona. You got to dap it up for the Corona.
Yo, listen.
Can nonfiction be the Southern slang for facts?
Ooh.
Whoa. Let's start it.
We just started something.
Yo, we just cracked it open on the day. What's today? March 23rd. We just cracked it open.
Hey, JR, Scum's coming out soon, right?
Oh.
Scum is coming out soon.
EP directly by your boy.
That guy to my left. Y'all's right.
Hey, that's going to be the new trend, too. People forget about that.
What's that?
I don't know if y'all around. Where you got behind me. Wind up.
Oh, yeah. You know me. You know me.
That's from the Patro.
My phone is.
Anyway, right now. I was trying to throw in that nonfiction.
No, yeah.
That's y'all Scum coming soon.
Yo. It is. And factual.
Shout out to AGP, of course, continue to do what they do. You know what I mean?
AGP's all over Scum Productions.
Absolutely.
Somehow, some way.
I hope it's going to be all over.
You know it.
A couple of tracks, you know what I mean? We ain't got to talk about it too much right now. We ain't got to really go into detail right now. That's pretty much.
They don't even care yet.
All they need to know is this next. It's coming next. From Jared the Geek. That's the next thing. No. And no. We're not going back there.
But what about merch?
Everything's on the way. We're gonna say it like that.
Well, merch is on the way.
More everything is on the way.
The shirts are back up on the Geeks.
Yeah, I didn't know everything was down, so I do apologize. But everything is back up. IamTheGeek.com is back, fully loaded. We back strapped up, and we're ready to roll.
Yes, sir.
Prepared.
Over communication,
man. It happens, bro.
It's a thing.
I just think I thrown into the wrong, you know, the wrong realms. That's it.
I mean, it happens every once in a blue moon.
Never mind.
What was you going to say?
Nothing.
What was you going to say?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yo, you know, I got in trouble in school for saying that. No, I got in trouble for saying blue hell.
Nonfiction. I was there.
Oh, that was so smooth.
I got in trouble in school for saying what in the blue hell.
Man, you say even worse. Oh, man, I think dude's name is Mitchell. And I have this whole theory about, like, kids who
Mitchell.
Are like, hey, man, we got a Mitchell haircut, everything. Mitchell voice.
God damn.
Mitchell posture, everything.
Yo, he was Mitchell. For real.
Lil Mitch. Shout out Lil Mitch.
Hey, man, not to prolong the long story back short. He said, what in the Sam Hill? Third grade, fam.
Son.
What in the Sam Hill?
I would have lost my shit.
He had to be a part of the group that misheard him.
So I would have lost my shit.
Whole group that tattled on kid, fell.
Oh, yeah.
He told the teacher he done cussed. He done got written up and everything.
Ain't that a bitch?
Damn. Yeah, he Lil Mitch.
Shout out Lil Mitch, man.
Shout out Lil Mitch, man.
I promise
to say that. No, we're telling your dad.
No.
Your dad's going to deal with it, so.
I've never heard what it was Sam Hill before my life.
Oh, yeah, nah, he's straight from the sticks.
I was like, bro, he cussed. And he cussed out loud.
That nigga said, no.
You sure get away with that?
Well, no.
We're telling your dad, Mitch, so
no.
Let your dad deal with it.
Let your damn dad deal with it.
Bet Mitchell Sr.'s not going to be fucking happy. He's going to beat your ass.
Let him make it, man.
I'm sorry. Shout out Lil Mitch.
Yo. What the nigga's like, yo, that was me.
That's actually not a funny fucking story, so fuck you guys. So Mitchell's gonna comment like me. Fuck the Conversation with Elephants podcast, honestly. It's not a funny story. Fuck my life up.
It has to stream down path of the wrong way.
I actually
way.
Straightened up after that, so fuck you guys.
You guys are such
an asshole. Got my act together.
The fuck around to be some, like a pilot or a lawyer or some shit right now.
Yo, Mitchell's gonna fuck this. Yo, he's gonna shut this podcast down before we even get started.
This thing's gonna be a real.
Oh, y'all thought y'all were about to get going?
That nigga be an executive somewhere we try to get on.
Think my name's fucking funny? Fuck you guys.
Think my fucking haircut's ugly?
I was born with it, so.
I was born with damn
my, that's all my dad can do, so. That's the only way he can cut.
Fucking funny.
You a hoe. Cut that nigga name. That nigga name is not
Yo,
ugly, bro.
That's Mitchell. Hilarious.
Mitchell.
Mitchell. You can't even call a nigga
we
hoe.
We fuck with Mitchell, though, so he shouldn't even hate on us.
Yo, you can't even call a hoe nigga's name. What's up, Mitchell?
Yo, get out. Leave this nigga alone, man.
You gotta say Mitch off top.
You gotta say Yo. Mitch, bro. You can't call this nigga Mitchell.
Money.
M. Money Mitch.
You can't even say M. That shit lame.
What up, M?
You hey, boo.
Hey, yo, Mitch. Hey, yo,
Mitch. Yes.
What's up, Z?
Yeah.
Hey, next subject.
Yo, shout out to this nigga. No, not shout out to this nigga. Never mind. We gonna shut that nigga out.
Who is it?
No, you know who it is. The nigga who said it.
I just want you to say it on the podcast.
I'm not falling for it. You a hoe for that shit. Boy, try to give me the slip up. I do this now. No. That nigga was 75. He was 35 years old at a middle school step competition.
We gotta get some composure going.
No, this man was 35 years old at a step competition.
Relax.
Trying to be cool.
What are you doing?
This man was too
Jesus,
old.
Jesus, man. Anyway, yo, episode 18. I appreciate y'all so much, Jared the Geek.
Yo.
This is fast.
Yeah, I'm just saying, though. I'm just saying it before we close it out, though. This man was too old to be at a middle school step competition.
Right. You with us. You're saying a lot, though, is what I'm saying.
But it's cool, though.
You're saying a lot right now.
You know
now.
Who he is. I ain't say his name.
You ain't got to at this point.
Niggas don't even know who I'm talking about. What's up, Z?
All right. Anyway, I am, like I said, J.I. the Geek. Hey, Judah the Shooter.
As
shooting
always.
All of the things that you need did. To be shot.
All of them.
And this man here who has said way too much this episode is my man Fat. We are the Elephants and you have just conversed with us and we are done with it.
You dig.
I'm out.
See y'all next Monday. You dig. Be safe. See y'all next Monday. You dig.
Quarantine up.
Peace up.
Yo. You have lost.